Hey guys, what's up? Greetings from Sacramento, California. I've been performing every day at the California State Fair. I'm a bit tired. It's been a long day juggling, unicycling, and making balloon animals. So, well, I'd like to show you my new origami model. This is, dun-da-da-da, a dragon, but not just any dragon. This is a flapping dragon. When you pull the legs apart, it flaps. And yeah, wanna learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of kami, white side up, let's valley fold diagonally in half. You could also use a 6-inch square, or you could use an 8.5-inch square of ordinary printer paper. Okay, let's unfold, and let's turn over, and rotate, and let's valley fold diagonally in half in this direction. And let's rotate 180 degrees, and let's rabbit ear this flap. So let's fold this edge to here. And you only need to fold right to this crease. And unfold, and let's fold this flap up. So we're folding this edge to here. And unfold, and now let's fold them both at the same time, and let's flatten to the right. And let's turn over right to left, and let's rabbit ear this flap. So fold up like this, just crease to right here. And unfold and fold up like this. And unfold, and let's fold them both at the same time. And this time, let's flatten to the left. Okay, let's unfold, and let's fold this flap to the right, and let's rotate, and now let's fold this flap up so that this corner goes to right here, and unfold, and let's turn over right to left, and let's fold this flap up to right here. And unfold, and let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap up so that this edge goes to this crease. And let's do the same thing on this flap. So let's fold this edge to here. Okay, now let's open here and put your finger into the pocket, and we're going to bring these two points together, and we're going to flatten, and you want to let this little flap right here just swing out as you flatten like this. Okay, so it was like here, and now it's like that. Okay, now let's rotate, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And turn over right to left, and let's do the same thing here. Let's fold this edge to this crease. Okay, and now let's fold this point to here. And unfold, and let's open here, and let's make a pleat right on this flap. So let's fold on this crease. and fold back down on this crease. And let's close it back up. Okay, let's turn over. And now we're going to pivot this flap up, and we want to pivot it how far? Well, we want this edge to align with this edge. So, about like that. And flatten. Okay, now let's zoom in. And now we're going to make a reverse fold right on this flap. So let's just push it in. What we want to do is make this edge align with this edge. So we're just going to bring them together like this. And now let's flatten it so that these edges align like that. Okay, now we're going to do something similar with this flap, this interior flap. So let's pull it out and let's fold this edge to this edge. This is a new crease, by the way. Like that. And let's close it back up. And as you close it, you want these edges to align. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this flap inside. So we're folding right between this point and this point. Just like that. From the inside, like that. And you can just clean this up by just pulling this out and flattening it down so that this is a simple triangle. Okay? And close it back up. Okay, let's do the same thing on the other side. So let's turn it over. And here we go. Let's make a reverse fold here. Like that. And a reverse fold on this interior layer right here. So these come together. It's a new fold. Do not use the existing fold. Like that. And like that, so that these align. And now let's take this flap and fold it inside. And just stretch that like that so that this is a triangle. Okay, there we go. And now let's do a similar sort of reverse fold on here. So we're folding this edge to right here. And really try to be exact on this fold. Okay, so it goes up like this, and let's extend it a little bit more, right up to here. And now we're going to fold right here and extend the fold all the way to the corner. So it's like that, and you see how this edge aligns with this edge. And let's do the same thing on the other side. So let's turn over and let's open here and fold this edge to right here. And make this fold extend all the way to the corner. Like that. Okay, now let's fold this flap the left, right on this edge. And let's open it and squash it. And when you squash it, you want to make sure that it's even, so let's turn it over. And this crease should align with this edge. Okay, let's turn it back over. And now we're going to petal fold, and we're going to use this existing crease to make the petal fold. So lift it up like this, and we're going to flatten here. So the fold goes from this point right to this point. And same thing here, flatten here. Now these two edges should not come together. There should be some space between them. Just like that. Okay, and let's close this up. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And let's do the same thing on this side. Let's fold this edge to here. And let's turn over. And now we're going to pull this flap out. We're sort of reverse folding it, or just unfolding it. Like this, and we're going to flatten it. And when we flatten it, we're going to end up making a crease, a new fold right inside there, just to allow it to flatten. There's the crease. It doesn't need to be very clean. It's going to be hidden. Okay. All right, now let's open this flap up, and we're going to make some pleats. So this is really sort of to taste, but we just want to make some nice looking pleats on the neck. So I'm going to fold about here. So this is a mountain fold, and you want your mountain fold to be perpendicular. And now let's make the valley fold right above it. And you want to just make it a very tiny bit above. So like that. We have our mountain and our valley fold like that. And now let's do the same thing. We're going to make a mountain fold right here. And this is to eye. However many pleats you want to make is okay. Just make them small. They don't need to be big. I'm going to try to clean this up a little bit, although it doesn't really matter. Okay. And a mountain fold here. And a valley right above it. And maybe two more. One and two. So I made five pleats, but if you're using 6-inch paper, I do not recommend making five. Three should be plenty. Okay, so there it is. And now I'm going to unfold these pleats. Oops. Okay, fix that up again. And fold this back like it was. And now, since these pleats are still in the paper, it's easy to crimp the neck. And this is how we do it. We just go up like that, and flatten. Just bend the neck up like this. And one more. Okay, and now what we're going to do is open these layers up . Just spread them out, and you want to reverse fold like this. So this is what it should look like. You see, we're just unfolding all of these folds so that it's just the raw corner like that. And now I'm going to fold this down. This is once again to taste. If you want a bigger head, you'll fold it further down. But we're just making an outside reverse fold right here, like that. And then on the sides of the neck, what we do is we're just going to press these together so it's like that, sort of like a box pleat, and like that. Okay, so now you can make a little reverse fold here if you want to make the shape of the head a little bit more round like that. And same thing on this side. Instead of having a square here, let's just reverse fold this up to taste. And now let's just shape the head like this, and this can go inside here, and if you want, you can make a little mouth, I don't know, something like that, and you can play with it, see if you can shape it a little bit better, but that's good enough for me. Okay, now let's do the wings. So for the wings, we're going to fold this flap down, and when we fold it down, we want to align these two edges. And now let's fold this flap up right on this edge, like that. And let's take this flap, the raw flap, and pull it out and fold it on top instead. So we're just reversing this crease. Okay, and unfold, and now let's fold this flap up. let's rotate. Okay, now let's fold this flap up so that this crease goes to this edge. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to this crease. Okay, and let's unfold this flap, and let's rotate, and now let's lift this crease up, and let's fold it right onto this crease. So like that, and once again, let's lift this crease up and fold it right to here. And again, let's take this crease, fold it, and fold it to here. And lastly, let's fold this edge to here. Okay, And now let's fold this whole thing behind right on the existing crease right here. And let's fold this edge to here. Okay, and let's open the wing, and we're going to make 4 reverse folds. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're just folding it up like that. And like that. Like that, and like that. Okay, so there's our dragon wing. And let's turn over and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's pull this flap down. This, aligning these edges, and fold it forwards, and unfold the flap, and fold it on top, and unfold, and let's fold it up so that this crease goes to right here, and unfold, and fold this edge to this crease, and let's unfold the flap, and let's form this crease and fold it to this crease, and do the same thing, make this crease into a fold and fold it up to this edge, and fold this crease and fold it up to here, and fold this edge to here. Okay, and let's make our 4 little reverse folds. One, two, three, four. And there's our dragon wing. Oops, let's fold it behind. And let's fold this edge to right here. There we go. Okay, so there are the wings. And now let's do the tail. Okay, so now what we're going to do is let's fold this flap up right on the interior edges right here. And now let's fold it back down. So we're folding right on this point. And this is really to taste, but about like that. Okay, and let's unfold. And we have to reverse these 2 creases. So this is a mountain fold, and this is a valley fold. And we're going to try to crimp it, but we're going to have trouble because of this little flap. So let's just make a little reverse fold. Like that. Okay, now it'll be able to crimp easily. We're just wrapping around these two edges right here. Okay, like that. Okay, so this is what it looks like inside. And now let's fold this flap down, and we're folding it right along this crease. Okay, and now let's unfold and let's reverse fold it. So just flip it around like this. And remake the pleat, the crimp. Okay, now you have to decide how big you want the arrow on the tail. So let's fold it about like this maybe. You could do thirds or something like that. Okay, and let's fold it back. And now let's fold this edge right here to here. So it's like that, and let's fold this edge to here. And now let's fold this flap down about like that, and same thing on the back side, and let's pull the tail out. So it's like that. Okay, and let's turn over. And now we're going to belly fold up to here like this. And unfold, and let's turn over, and let's fold it up on this side. And now let's unfold, and now let's open up, and we're going to spread sink. So open up and just sink it down like this, and this gets flattened like this, and close it back up. Okay, so that's what it looks like. And now you can put some pleats in the tail like we did in the neck. So let's open it up, and let's first fold up like this. We want this first fold to go just a tiny bit above this edge, like that. And it should be perpendicular to this crease. And let's fold it down. And let's make a couple more. So let's fold about like this, and let's fold it down, and one more. And fold it down. Okay, and once again, let's unfold and let's flatten. And now we're going to do our little crimps, which will bend the tail back down. Like this, and like this, and one more, like that. And you can open the tail up a little bit and shape it to taste. Maybe try to hide this white line with a little wrinkle folding. So, like that. Okay. And let's pull the wings forward. Open them up. Okay. And zoom out a little bit. So here we have our dragon. And to make it flat, you just hold here and pull. Now, before you do this, you want to be careful not to rip, not to tear the paper right here. So just be careful and just pull it out just very gently like that. You see, I'm just pulling here, and as you pull out, the wings flap. Just like that. And there is your dragon. And if you want, you can try to shape the body a little bit more. So I'm gonna do that now. But here is the dragon. You can finish right here. Okay, so I'm gonna just, let's see. Put a little shape into the body right here. And a little shape underneath on the belly. That'll make the legs look a little bit longer. And a little shaping here, you can just open this up. And if you want, you can make a little shaping on the neck. This can sort of be square. that. And let's see, where else can we shape it? You can close these flaps up like that. There it is. And let's see if it still flaps. It does. And there it is. There's the dragon. Okay, well, I hope you had some luck at folding that, and let me know what you think. All right, have a good one. See you later.